Hello everyone, I'm Gary Gustafson, better known as Gus, and I lead wildlife hikes for the Deschutes Land Trust. Today, I thought it'd be useful to talk about evidence of wildlife left in the form of scat. We know that the animal has come by because he or she has left us an offering. And we'll start with ungulates, some of the most common mammals that you will encounter. In Central Oregon, the most common of all is going to be the mule deer. Mule deer will leave pellets approximately of this shape. And by the way, folks, it's not always a good idea to pick up wildlife scat, particularly if it's fresh. But this is dry. I've had it for over a year in my garage, so I'm not hesitating to pick it up. But wash your hands afterwards if you should pick some up. So, mule deer looks like this, somewhat elongated. You've all seen it in your yards. It can be broken open, and in the winter time, you can see that it's full of browse. Browse means little twigs and what leaves are left to get in the winter time. Okay, we'll move up the scale and take a look at a little larger scat, and it happens to be darker, and as you might imagine, this is elk. Here in Central Oregon, they are primarily grazers. Remember that, mule deer are browsers and elk are primarily grazers. In the wintertime though, they do browse because it's very hard to get down to the grass. And when you break it open, you'll see grass and only a few twigs. So elk is larger, also oval-shaped. All right, people often ask me, what about cougar and bobcat? This happens to be a piece of cougar scat. And again, it's been dried for almost 2 years, so I normally wouldn't handle it, but in this case, it's totally dry. You can see the fur in it. Cat scat has segments and it's also blunt at the ends. Very different from a canine scat, which will be pointy end and sometimes a little segmented, but not nearly as much as this. Also, if you'll notice, it's much bigger. Bobcat looks exactly like it, just a bit smaller. People wonder about black bear, and this one I'm just going to hold up here without taking it out. This isn't dried out enough. Black bear eat almost anything, primarily vegetation, but they're opportunists. They'll eat squirrels they can dig out. They'll eat carrion if they can find it. They'll scavenge, but most of the time they're eating vegetation, grass, skunk cabbage, anything like that, digging up roots, eating vegetation. And so they're scat, usually dark, but in the fall or late summer, it'll have berries in it and stems. But other than that, it could have most anything in it. But you know, it'll always be spread out and dark. So this, okay, is small. It's segmented, it's brown. This means that it's meat when it's that dark brown. Mm. What I can't tell, unfortunately, is I can tell it's a dog-like animal and most likely a coyote, but also could be a dog. We're on a road where dogs also come down, and because it's dark and because I don't see any fur in it, it's either a coyote that has eaten meat or it's a dog. So thanks for listening. The important thing, folks, is to get out there, explore the world that you live in, and you'll be surprised what you find.